In this tutorial, we'll create a battery clip using synchronous sheet metal modeling techniques in SolidEdge. First, open SolidEdge software, and from the new menu, select isometric sheet metal. Then from the ribbon bar, start the rectangle by center command and hover the mouse cursor between the X and Y axis to highlight the plane. Click the lock icon or press F3 to lock the plane for sketching. Press Ctrl H to orient the selected plane parallel to the screen. Then click at the origin to start drawing the rectangle. Type in 120 as the length and 20 for the width of the rectangle. Then click inside the rectangle to select the region. Open the material table from the command bar. Select galvanized steel as the material. Specify 2 as the thickness and specify 2 for bend radius. Next, click in the graphics area to create the tab. Select the two end faces of the tab with the control key pressed. Next, drag the steering wheel to create flanges. Select the far end faces of the flanges to change their width. Check off symmetric and thickness chain design intent. Then start the break corner command and select the radius corner and face options on the command bar. Select the faces of the extended flanges and type in 4 as the radius. Press enter or right click in an empty space to create the feature. To create the slots, draw a line by locking on the near side face of the extended flange. Use the smart dimension and distance between commands to define the line length and position. Next, start the slot command. Go to slot options and change the slot width to 5 and select the arc end option. Change the slot extents to through all and select the line to create slots on both extended flanges. Click to create the slots and right click again to finish the command. Select the near side of the tab to create another flange. Then drag the steering wheel to start creating the flange. On the command bar, select the option for creating a partial flange and create bend outside. Click anywhere to create the partial flange without specifying the height or width. At this stage, use the smart dimension command to define the line length of the partial flange. Click the lock icon on the dimension edit box to prevent modification of the flange width when its position changes. Next, use the distance between command to specify the distance of the partial flange from one end of the tab. Select the partial flange from the Pathfinder and start the mirror command. From the Pathfinder, select the right or YZ plane to mirror the partial flange. Use the break corner command again to round off the partial flanges using half the width as a radius. Select the partial flange from the Pathfinder and position the steering wheel to the center of the bend of the flange. Next, drag the torus of the steering wheel and type in an angle to rotate the flange in a direction away from the flange. Note that the mirrored flange also rotates with the partial flange. This completes the creation of the battery clip using synchronous sheet metal modeling techniques. In this tutorial, you learned how to assign material bend radius and thickness and create a tab, how to create flanges using the steering wheel, how to modify flange thickness by choosing the correct design intent settings, how to create slots on a sheet metal flange, how to create partial flanges and control their size and position using lock dimensions, how to break corners on flanges in a single operation, and how to use the steering wheel to make synchronous edits to the sheet metal flanges.